Hello everyone! We are starting a series of tutorials where we'll share animated intro ideas. For this tutorial, we'll include a template you'll be able to download and adjust to your taste. Let's get started! Launch VSDC and create a new project. Upload the background image and set its duration at 3 seconds. If the size of your image doesn't fit the size of the scene, use the auto crop feature. Now make a double click on it and add a rectangle shape to the scene. Select its color and use the button named Set the same size as the parent has. Go to the Blending Modes menu and select Multiply. Switch the filling type from solid to gradient, then adjust the gradient vector. Now let's add the zoom effect. Find Levels and select the following option: Linear Parameter Change Along a Trajectory. Now, if you look at the graph, here are the points on the timeline we'll be working with: 0 point, 1 second, 1.25 seconds, 2 seconds. Go back to the main timeline and add the text for your intro. Adjust the text size, it should take around 60 to 80% of the scene. Now align it to the left border. Make a double click on the text and select the movement icon from the toolbar. Imagine the text is divided into 3 parts: the beginning, the middle, and the ending. So you'll need to create 3 movement vectors. The first one for the very beginning of the video, it's the 0 point on the timeline. Place the second vector a second later. Place the third vector 2 seconds later. Time to add motion blur. In the Properties window, find Blur Distances and set Linear Parameter Change Along the Trajectory. On the graph, duplicate the same control points you created earlier: 0 point, 1 second, 1.25 seconds, 2 seconds. The control points are ready. Now create 2 additional points and set their values at 50. One will be between the first and the second, and another one between the third and the fourth control points. Once you do this, the text will start getting blurred as it moves. Let's switch back to the main timeline and add the second piece of text. It will be much smaller. Remember to align it to the center of the scene. To make it a little more interesting, we'll use a 1 second long distortion effect. Once you've added the effect, adjust it in the Properties window. Select Type Whirlpool angle delta 0.1850. To top it off, let's add a fade-in effect. Now this piece of text will be gradually appearing in the scene. Great job! Finally, let's add a couple more pieces of text. Say, one will be our subscribe button and another one will be credits. Convert these two lost pieces of text into a sprite and select the following parameters in the Properties window. Use as container? No. Show effects? Yes. Fill background? No. The sprite should start displaying from the third control point, which is located at 1.25 seconds on the timeline. Apply the fade-in effect to the sprite as well. And we're done! Was this tutorial helpful? Please let us know in the comments below and hit the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet.